Hi, hope you're having a great day. You're watching JUG Entertainment, and for this video, I'll be giving you my breakdown of the new Superman Lois episode 6, which is actually a very nice and interesting episode. It's a little bit late, the video's a little bit late, but I have a really nice breakdown and theories and reviews and everything for this episode, so I really hope you enjoy this video. I think it's going to be a really fun and enjoyable video, and I think you're going to get a lot of it. Like, be like, oh my god, this happened, oh my god, that's true, so I hope you enjoy it. But before I start, just make sure to leave a like if you do end up enjoying it. It would be very, very helpful to the video, so please leave a like. I still subscribe for a lot of content. I do one of these videos every single week whenever Superman Lois episode comes out, so that way I can review and keep up with the theories and break down each episode. So yeah, if you're interested in that content, then definitely subscribe. I also have a lot of Batman content coming up, so subscribe to that as well, and leave a comment below on your own thoughts on this episode. I'm definitely very curious, so tell me that down in the comments. Okay, now let's get started. Alright, so let's start with the opening scene. And the opening scene is with Bizarro, the Bizarro world, kind of. And we see, like, Bizarro's, like, old house and everything. And to make it, like, kind of small, he basically kills Ally from his universe. And he fights Lana there, who has superpowers, who was working for Ally in that universe. And he takes the stone. So that's basically the short version. But it's actually more interesting to that. There was actually some pretty cool stuff in there. For example, here we learn that Bizarro was captured using X-Kryptonite. So he was captured by Ally or whatever. And he escapes the base. And he fights Lana, who seems to be Superwoman. It's because she has, like, powers. Or she seems to be, like, a Superman of America. But in that Bizarro universe, she's super interesting. So here she has powers, which I think is really, really cool. I either wonder if they're going to bring that in into our universe, like whenever the season finale comes in or something, and she's going to have powers. I think that would be super, super interesting. But since I really like Lana, I think that's really cool. In the comics, she gets her powers from a blood transfusion from Superman that gave her powers. That's how she gets her powers. And since I'm a big fan of Lana in this show, like, I think she's done perfectly in this show. Like, she's a really strong character. I really enjoy seeing her parts in the show. Then I would really love to see this. I think that would be super awesome. I think that would be such a huge level up for her. But we'll see what happens. I do think that's very interesting, though, so we'll see what happens, but I did think that was a pretty nice thing to add into that Bizarro world. In this Bizarro world, we also see, whenever we're looking at the house of Bizarro, where it's, like, all broken and everything, we see there's, like, a family picture with Jordan and Jonathan and Lois and Clark, and here we see that two people in there, and that picture have an X on them. And that's Jonathan and Lois. They both have an X on their faces, or on their bodies, kind of. In fact, I'll put it right here in an image. They both have an X on their faces. I'm sorry if it's bad quality, but yeah. However, Jordan doesn't have an X on his face, so I do wonder what that means. I'm just like, what could that possibly mean? I think we might see a Jordan Bizarro version here. I don't really know what that means, but Jonathan and Lois do have an X, so I'm assuming that they died in that universe or that something happened. We're not entirely sure yet, but I'm sure we're going to get the context of it since it's still very early on. Another thing that I have a question is, how did Clark get all those scars? Because everybody else seemed normal in that picture, and then whenever they were fighting, Lana seemed normal, Ally seemed normal. So I do kind of wonder how he had those scars. We'll find out very soon, I hope. We still have a lot in the season left. Like, we're still really close to, like, we're not even halfway there yet, so we still have a lot of time to find out. However, that's very interesting that they were crossed up and that nobody else seems to have scars, so we'll see where that goes. I think we're gonna see more of the Bizarro world more and more every time as episodes go on. I think we're gonna see more and more, so I'm very excited. I'm honestly very excited. I'd like to explore this Bizarro world. For example, he also posts, like, a gas of kryptonite, which makes him stronger, which I thought was super ironic, since, you know, in our universe, Clark Kent is his weakness is kryptonite. Sorry, here, and X kryptonite is what is powering up all these people. However, in their universe, X kryptonite is the weakness for Bizarro, and kryptonite is, like, making him stronger. So I thought that was super fun and interesting. I was like, oh, that's pretty cool. So yeah, I really enjoyed that. And like I said, at the end, we do see that Bizarro steals Ally's necklace from the universe and kills her, and then he comes to his universe. So that's interesting. We also learned that the Bizarro universe and our universe, which I don't mean actually our universe, like the universe of where Clark Kent and everything goes on. So that universe and the Bizarro universe were once one, and then they split. We don't know why they split, but we know that they split. So that's very interesting. Maybe the angle is to merge them back together from Ally, perhaps. I'm not entirely sure, but that is very interesting. All right, moving on to that, we see that Superman then goes to the funeral of the Superman of America that died. The two of them with Anderson. However, Superman has to go on an emergency because he has to save some citizens from an avalanche, which looked really awesome. That scene where he saves people from the avalanche looked really, really awesome. The cinematography there was beautiful. Like, wow, that looked really awesome. Especially whenever Superman was, like, right there with the sunlight on the back and everything. That looked incredible. I was like, that's awesome. Anderson had just received orders to catch Bizarro immediately because these two Superman of America died. Like, that caused them to, like, put a lot more pressure on Anderson and to do anything he needs to catch Bizarro, which I thought was super interesting. And to drive Anderson even further to madness, and the funeral, one of the mother of the Superman of America that died, loses it with him, and she starts screaming at him and slaps Anderson. So I thought that was very interesting. And in this scene, I actually kind of got the like John Walker vibes from Falcon Winter Soldier. It kind of reminded me a lot of John Walker, where we see like John Walker slowly getting drove to madness. So it kind of reminded me of that. Not as good as John Walker. Like, I thought John Walker was the best part of Falcon Winter Soldier. I don't think Anderson is nowhere near the level of John Walker, but I did get those John Walker vibes. And if they could dive more into that, I would actually really enjoy that. I would like, okay, we're getting more of this kind of character exploration that actually has a lot more layers to him. That would be super awesome. So then Superman tells Anderson that he captured Bizarro, but that he needs the crystal as it's dangerous. But he has to leave an emergency because, like I said, he had to save this small Russian city from an avalanche. So this also drives Superman even worse. I mean, Anderson even worse. He's like, he just left in the middle of a really important conversation. So you can definitely see why Anderson would be frustrated with Superman. I think I would probably be frustrated with Superman too. He isn't making things better though. He's not cooperating, but at the same time, he's been left in the dark on everything, and he wants to get a better idea of what he's dealing with. So you know, that's what I'm saying. I kind of get John Walker vibes because he's not a likable character, but he's understandable character. He's a that type of thing. So that's definitely interesting for me. I think that's pretty cool, pretty fascinating. Hopefully, I can get more John Walker vibes from Anderson because that would be awesome. So this drives Anderson to feel the need to have to capture Superman. So he calls Superman to the base at the end of the episode, where he gets surrendered by the Red Sun to weaken him, which I thought was very interesting. They keep using the Red Sun. We saw that last season whenever what we thought was Captain Luthor was fighting Superman and surrendered him with the Red Sun. That was super cool. Who actually ended up being Steel or John Henry Irons, whatever. But we saw that again here. So honestly, he needs a protection for that Red Sun thing because he's definitely very, very weak there. But here we get an amazing fight. Like, this is an amazing fight scene. It's a one-shot fight, which is, I think, was really awesome. I love that whenever there's just a one-shot fight. That's why we like Daredevil a lot and all those type of things. So I really love one-shot fights. And we see Superman fight soldiers that are attacking him, and they just keep coming and coming. Like, they don't stop. While Superman is definitely weekend, and it's a really great shot. I think that whole thing was very nicely shot. The action was really nice. The cinematography looked awesome, and you can feel Superman trying his best. You can feel that he still had power. Like, whenever he would punch them a lot, I was like, oh my god, this guy just flew. It was really good. I really liked the episode. I was like, that's awesome. That's a really, really good fight. Like, awesome directing from the director. Ultimately, however, Anderson shoots him with a kryptonite bullet and captures him and sends him to be in prison with his brother Morgan Edge, or Tel-Ro, whatever you want to call that. And yeah, that's the end of Clark's story for this episode. And I thought that was actually really, really interesting. I can't wait to see the next episode how this ends up breaking down. But we do see that he's going to be spend some more time with Tel-Ro. Obviously, they're going to go for the redemption arc for Tel-Ro. I think he has a lot of things that can still be redeemed. And I think that this episode might either be his redemption or the way to kind of drive Superman more towards the, like, he's trying to drive Superman to the Or evil side, to be like, wow, you sacrificed yourself for all these humans, look at where they put you now, which I think would be a lot of sense. So it's definitely gonna make for a really interesting episode. I don't know how it's gonna end up working out, but it's gonna make for a really, really interesting episode, and I can't wait for it. I love Morgan Edge, or Tower, whatever you call it. I love the episode we got with him earlier in the season, and I think next episode is gonna be even better because they're gonna be stuck in the same cell and they're gonna have to have a lot of character development with each other, which I think is gonna be super, super awesome. I do think that they might free each other though. I think they might, Tower might go free. And we'll see where that goes. I think that's going to be super interesting. So yeah, let's see what happens in the next episode. But it has to be kind of like a finale, like a mid-season finale type of thing, because we're going to go on break until the next episode. So it's going to be like a lot of reviews and everything. So I can't wait to see what they actually saved up for us, because it sounds really, really awesome. Okay, then at the start of the episode, moving on to a different storyline. At the start of the episode, Lois's dad, Sam, brings Lucy Lane to the house of Lois so they can clear the differences, which actually starts working out a lot. I was like very surprised. I was like, oh, this is actually starting to work out. And it starts working out because they won't talk about Allie at all. They only talk about family. Like, Lucy finds it very nice and fascinating that Jordan and Jonathan both play football. And she seems to know a lot about football. Like, she's talking about them with football and, like, dispositions and players and everything, which is super interesting. I actually find that pretty cool. And, yeah, that was super interesting. They really seem to connect a lot. She even wanted to go to the game, and she did go to the game. However, this is where it all goes downhill as Lucy brings up Allie, and she says that at least she knows that she was right. And Lois is like, she's still dangerous. And obviously, they disagree. So Lucy leaves, ending on a bad note. But it was going pretty well into that point. So it was like, ooh, we were so close. Like, on Star Wars, you were at the verge of greatness. So honestly, that sucks. And obviously, Sam was pretty bummed out that didn't work out, because he really wanted that to work out. We'll see where they keep bringing out this storyline, though. I'm definitely very curious to see what happens with Lucy Lane. I don't see, like, a clear path for her to be like, oh, she's going to go full evil. She's going to go full good. Because she's honestly, like, in the middle. So I don't know what they're going to do with her in this show. But the fact that they brought her in is doing for some great character development. But I do wonder what the end goal is with Lucy Lane. I'm definitely very curious to see that. We also didn't get to see the other girl from the newspapers, which I actually kind of enjoyed because I thought she was getting kind of annoying, so kind of taking a break from that kind of helped. So that was good. But yeah, I still really like Lois's story, how she's involved in this personally as well. And I love the dynamic that they have as a family, both Sam, Lois, and Lucy. I think they're a very broken family, but I really enjoy seeing the dynamic that they have. So that's great. They're really exploring that very, very nicely. Then we get to see the kids, Jonathan and Jordan. And we find out that, and Jordan finds out that he's taking X Kryptonite. That Jonathan's taking X Kryptonite whenever they're playing the football game, and he realizes that he's taking X Kryptonite because he hears the conversation between Jonathan and his girlfriend. So that's really interesting. They start to fight, but Grandpa Lane stops them because Grandpa Lane's to the save. So yeah, that's really interesting. They're definitely going to not fix the differences because in the preview for next episode, they seem to be fighting all the time and everything. So we'll see where this goes. I think Jordan's going to snitch him out. I think so. Or Jonathan's going to have to do something really bad to Jordan for him not to snitch out. So it's going to be a super, super interesting conversation and kind of like battle here. But yeah, we're starting to see Jonathan kind of go towards the evil side. We have seen these set images though, so I don't know what this is. I think this might be the Bizarre World because this looks like nothing like Jonathan from our world. So we'll see where that goes. I'm very, very curious to see what happens to Jonathan, but we'll find out. I think he might join Allie, to be honest. I think he might join Allie, perhaps. However, we also find out in that football game that some football players are sick and they're taking X Kryptonite, meaning that Jonathan will have some consequences for taking that X Kryptonite. So which I think that's going to be very interesting. I wonder how hard those consequences are. Like, are they really severe, or are they just mid? I'm definitely curious. Like, I'm kind of curious to see how serious this is because we haven't gotten to that scope yet. However, like I said, my prediction is that Jonathan is probably going to join Allie or something. I don't know, but these set images definitely don't look like the Jonathan that I see in this show. So we'll find out. It doesn't feel the same style. You know what I mean? We also had the fallout of the quinceañera from the last episode, where Kyle's trying his best to get back with Lana while she's trying to make up her mind. So in that process, she talks to Clark, which I think was a really nice conversation. She talks to the girl that Kyle cheated with to make up her mind. And there, the girl tells her that he broke the cheating off because he was worried about Sarah's mental health because she was going through a hard time and everything. Which ultimately leads Lana to kick Kyle out of the house. She tells him that she wants him out of the house because she feels like he would have not stopped cheating if it wasn't because of her daughter, but it would have not been because of Lana. So that makes sense. I think Lana has a good point. So she wants Kyle out of the house, which I thought was very, very interesting. All these scenes though were very nicely acted. All the scenes, the one where they kicked out, the one where Kyle's trying to get back and everything, I think all the scenes were very nicely acted. I think they were perhaps the best acted scenes in this episode. I think they were very nicely done. And I wonder what this is going to have, what effect this is going to have on Lana's campaign. I'm definitely very curious on that. Like, I don't know, because they kind of abandoned that plot this episode. So let's see next episode if they retake that campaign for Lana type of thing. I'm definitely curious to see what happens there. She might maybe get lost in her work, perhaps. Kyle's not just going to get back with Lana next episode because this is not the type of show that is. So I wonder where this drives Kyle as well. I think he might join Allie as well because I think this might drive Kyle a little bit towards madness or a little bit more towards sadness and depression. So we'll see where this goes. I'm definitely very, very interested. But I also really like Lana as a character. She seems like a really strong character, great person. I really like Lana. All right. I also like every scene between Lana and Clark. In this episode, we got a scene whenever they were talking, which I thought was very nice. It's just so nice to see like these two people that were like romantically involved in the past kind of become these type of friends that just want the best for each other. I really enjoy that. I think they have a really nice dynamic, and I thought that was great. I really do enjoy that. So I just want more scenes between Lana and Clark. I think they just make for some great, great friends. Like, I think they it's just so nice to have some friends, to see some friends want the best for each other. Like, I really like it. So we really like the dynamic and the show, and this episode definitely proved that as well. So yeah, this episode of Raw was a really, really good episode. Definitely not a filler at all. I feel like this season we haven't had any fillers. The story just keeps going and going and going, and this episode definitely proved it. It had some great things into it. It had a great fight scene. Get to see the Bizarre World. It provided us more information with what this Bizarre World means. And I think that ultimately we're going to see Jonathan probably join Allie as well as maybe Kyle. And it's going to be very interesting to see that. So yeah, hopefully we get more info about it next episode. But I'm very excited to see Morgan Edge / Talro be with Clark. That's going to be super, super fun. So yeah, that's going to be super cool. And also, I want to see John Henry Irons again. Like, I know he's been benched because he got hurt, but where is he? I want to see more of him. So hopefully we get him back soon. But yeah, that was this episode's review, breakdown, and theory. Hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then please leave a like. It would be very, very helpful. As well, subscribe for, like I said, a video of these every single week that you definitely enjoy. And a lot of Batman coverage. Like, I just saw the Batman. It was great. I'm going to do a spoiler review, probably character shrine, probably top 10 scenes, and then, like, I don't know, like a sequel video or whatever. It's going to be very fun. So definitely subscribe for all that type of stuff. And leave a comment down below with your own thoughts on this episode, your own theories, your own favorite scenes, anything you want to tell me about this episode, leave that down in the comments. And yeah, that'll be it for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day. And this is JJ Entertainment. Out.